fire crackling, a spreading blaze as flames sweep across a dormant field. But this fire was deliberately set, part of a realistic training exercise for students in UT's Herbert College of Agriculture and Forestry. Today, their classroom is the Forks of the River Wildlife Area in Knoxville.
So we're real proud of it at the University of Tennessee that we have this partnership. We're able to get the students this kind of training because they're going to be working in fire more than likely in a career.
Professor Chris Graves says this is much more than resume building. Students earn a lifetime federal certification to be basic wildland firefighters, the training done by the U.S. Forestry Service and Tennessee Division of Forestry.
Before the students reached this point, they spent a week doing other training that included how weather impacts firefighting, securing fire lines, use of equipment, and safety.
Firing!
Here at the firing devices station, students learn to start fires with flare guns. Kennedy Calloway is on hand, interested in wildlife rehab. We've all seen the horrific images from Australia, and Kennedy says this training could help her save animals someday.
So I think it's important that we, you know, think of every aspect of how fire affects not just us and our homes, but also the animals and their habitat.
Students also see how fire, prescribed burns, can be a natural management tool. Sometimes you burn on purpose to prevent more damage. If ground is already charred, a destructive wildfire has nothing to grab onto. Ecosystems need fire.
But fire's just as important as the wind and the rain. But we need to educate the public and do a better job of that, about the importance of fire, and then also train our students so that they can go on and put more fire on the ground in a controlled manner.
Dozens of UTIA students were certified firefighters by day's end. The power of fire can be devastating and helpful. That's what these students learn here, that either way, fire is a force that must be contained. This is Charles Denny reporting.